The images that you are about to see are not isolated cases. They represent industry standards for animals raised for milk. Cows, buffaloes, and other animals raised for milk have many of the same basic needs as we do, including food, water, shelter, companionship, and the freedom to move around. They feel pain, just as we do, and they understand the world in which they live. Otherwise, they could not survive. Animals raised for milk are forced to endure enormous pain and suffering. They have been turned into milk-producing machines by an industry that has become increasingly industrialized over recent decades. In the year 2007, India produced almost 100 million tons of milk, which is 15% more than the US and 3 times more than China. Like all mammals, animals raised for milk need to become pregnant in order to produce milk. Typically, animals raised for milk are made to give birth to a calf every year, which means they are both lactating and pregnant for at least 7 months a year. Within 3 months of giving birth, a cow is made pregnant again, at times through artificial methods. Artificial insemination is a process by which sperm is collected from the male, processed, stored, and artificially introduced into the female reproductive tract for the purpose of conception. Animals are artificially inseminated by barefoot healers who ignore even minimum standards of care. PETA investigators observed that the artificial insemination guns were rarely sterilized, that syringes and needles were used repeatedly on different animals without being sterilized, and that the barefoot healers shoved their bare, soapy hands into the animals' uteruses, causing the cows immense pain and exposing them to potential infections and diseases. Cows and buffaloes raised for milk in India today are milked over and over using machines which are able to extract more milk than the animals would yield easily. Because workers aren't always paying attention, the machines often continue to run even after the animals' udders are empty, causing them a lot of pain. Most cows raised for the dairy industry are intensively confined, leaving them unable to fulfill their most basic desires, such as nursing their calves. They are treated like milk-producing machines and are given hormones that cause them to produce more milk. Most cows are chained by their necks in narrow stalls, unable to stretch or move normally. Lack of proper food causes them to suffer from digestive problems, and lack of exercise causes lameness. Many dairy farms do not have drainage facilities, electricity, or a place to dispose of the animal's waste. Buffaloes stand several feet deep in foul-smelling slush. They suffer from skin infections, foot disease, tuberculosis, and other illnesses. The following are just some of the horrors PETA investigators observed. A newborn calf was found tied tightly to a stump. Animals were covered in their own feces. Because nobody attended to a buffalo who had gone into labor, her calf died during birth. Some buffaloes were bleeding from their vaginas, but workers paid no attention to this. Milk containers were kept near open drains, causing potential contamination. Flies were all over the tabelas and were sitting on milk containers and buckets, potentially contaminating the milk. Bull calves, who are of no commercial value to the dairy industry, are tied up with ropes so short that they cannot even lift their heads. Very often these calves are sold to slaughterhouses and killed for their skin. Oxytocin. Oxytocin is a Schedule H drug, which means it cannot be bought or sold without a prescription. However, its use in the dairy industry, although illegal, is rampant, as the drug causes cows to produce more milk. Oxytocin causes cows to experience severe stomach cramps similar to labor pains and weakens their bones. It also causes them to stop producing milk after just 3 years, at which time the cows are often let loose to fend for themselves in the streets. Under natural conditions, a cow can live up to 18 years, but cows raised for milk are only about 6 or 7 years old when they are sent to the slaughterhouse to be killed for their meat and skin. Cows are transported to states where they can legally be killed. The animals are shooed and then roped together in preparation for the harrowing death march, which can last several days. Handlers pull the cattle by ropes through their noses and twist their necks, horns and tails to keep them moving. They lead, or rather force, the cattle down embankments and in and out of trucks without ramps, causing the animals injuries such as broken pelvises, legs, ribs and horns. Another way handlers keep the animals moving is by rubbing chili peppers and tobacco into their eyes. As many as half of the animals will already be dead by the time they arrive at the slaughterhouse. The survivors are often killed in full view of each other. And instead of the required quick slice across the throat with a sharp knife, they are generally killed through hacking and sawing with a dull blade. It all comes down to pain and suffering. Not intelligence, not strength, not social class or civil right. Pain and suffering are in themselves bad and should be prevented. Say no to that slice of cheese or glass of milk. There are so many nutritious, delicious and cruelty-free recipes available now. Soya milk is available almost everywhere in India. Soya is not only cruelty-free, but also rich in protein and nutritious. Urge your local municipal corporation to ensure that basic animal welfare laws are enacted and enforced, and that tabelas all across the city are hygienically maintained. Visit PETAindia.com to read our vegetarian starter kit, full of tips for healthy dairy-free living.